Hello students, today we are going to revise the judiciary chapter. As you know that this chapter will come in your unit test exam. So let's revise some of the important topics which may come in your exam. Now see the first question. Which article gives right to life? Which article guarantees all the citizens of the country right to life? And the article is Article 21. It is a very important article and it protects the life of the citizen. Until and unless someone has done very severe crime, not even the law, you know, in the rarest of the rare case, the death punishment is given. So Article 21 guarantees right to life. Now see the question number 2. What is the full form of PIL? Dear students, you know that in 1980s, the Supreme Court has devised a mechanism to help those people who are poor, who are illiterate, who don't have the time to go to the court again and again to get the justice. To help those people, they devised a new mechanism called PIL. Now in PIL, a person can write just a letter or a telegram to the court for getting the justice for the public. Now what is the full form of PIL? The full form of PIL is Public Interest Litigation. Now see the question number 3. What is the full form of FIR? Now FIR is the term which you on and often comes across. You must have heard about FIR from someone in the neighborhood. You may have heard about this term in the movies or the serial. So what is the full form of FIR? The full form of FIR is First Information Report, and it is written by the police. Now the next question, who appoints the judges? We know that in India, one of the main features of our constitution is the separation of power. There are three organs of the government, legislature, executive and judiciary, and they are having their defined work and they do not interfere in each other's work. Now in the case of judiciary, who appoints the judges? Now the judges are appointed by the president of the country. Now the next question, which is the highest court in India? You know that in India we are having a hierarchical judicial system. The topmost court is the Supreme Court, then comes the High Court, and then comes the district courts, isn't it? So the topmost court is the Supreme Court. Then Dowry Death comes under which category? There are two categories of law, civil law and the criminal law. So when the crime is very heinous, when it is related to the killing of someone, murder of someone like that, those cases comes under the criminal law. So Dowry Death will come under the criminal law. You have read about the Sudha Goyal case, that in Sudha Goyal's case, the in-laws they were accused of killing, burning the Sudha alive. So that Dowry Death came under the criminal law. Now the next question, who is the final interpreter of the constitution? In case of any confusion related to constitution, who is going to clarify it? Who is having the final authority? Who is the final interpreter of the constitution? It is the judiciary. Judiciary is the final interpreter of the constitution. Thank you.